Chemical reactivity, chapter number 8. Today we are going to do an introduction about metals and electropositive character. What are metals? Metals are the elements, except hydrogen, which are electropositive and form cations by losing electrons. What is electropositive character? Metals have the tendency to lose their valence electrons. This property of metal is termed as electropositivity or metallic character. The more easily a metal loses its electrons, the more electropositive it is. The number of electrons lost by an atom of a metal is called its valency. For example, sodium atom can lose one electron to form a positive ion or cation. So the valency of sodium metal is 1. Similarly, zinc metal can lose 2 electrons from its valence shell, therefore its valence is 2. Metals can be characterized by very reactive metals, moderately reactive metals, and least reactive metals or noble metals. Very reactive metals include potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, and aluminum. As you know, these are the from group 1A, 2A, and 3A. Less reactive metals or moderately reactive metals are zinc, iron, tin, and lead. These are belonging to the D block elements. Least reactive or noble metals, they are also from the D block, copper, mercury, silver, and gold. These are also known as inert metals. Metals reactivity, its strength. Right to left, reactivity increase. It means 1A having high metallic character, then 2A. Metallic character is increased from as you move from right to left, and it will be decreased as you move from left to right. At the bottom, metallic character is also increases. So highly metallic group is 1A and highly metallic element is cesium instead of francium. Why? Because francium is radioactive. Therefore, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium, these are belong to group 1A, highly metallic elements from the periodic table. And cesium having highly electropositive element. Okay? Metallic character increases at the right side of the left side of the periodic table, and it will decrease at the right side of the periodic table. Metallic character increases at the left side of the periodic table. 1A and 2A are the highly metallic characters group instead of 6A, 7A. Now, most reactive, least reactive. For example, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium. They are from the 1A, 2A, and 3A. These are the highly reactive elements. 4A is carbon. Then zinc, iron, tin, lead. These are the less reactive metals. And copper, silver, gold, platinum. These are the least reactive metals, or they are also considered as the noble metal or inert metals. Now, some characteristic or chemical properties of metals. They easily lose electron and form positive ion or cations. Number 2, they readily react with oxygen to form basic oxide. Number 3, they usually form ionic compound with non-metal. And number 4, they have metallic bonding. they have metallic bond. Now, some physical properties or characteristics. Almost all metals are solid in nature except mercury. They have high melting and boiling points except alkali metals. They possess metallic luster and can be polished. They are malleable, can be hammered into sheet, ductile, can be drawn into wires and give up a tone when it heats. They are good conductors of heat and electricity. They have high densities. They are hard except sodium and potassium. Now, we can classify according to their reactivity, very reactive, fairly reactive, not very reactive, and most unreactive or inert or noble metals. Very reactive include potassium, sodium, lithium, calcium. They are from the group 1A. Fairly reactive, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, 2A and G block element. Not very reactive, not react at a room temperature, at high temperature, iron, tin, lead and copper. Inert metal or most unreactive metals are silver, gold and platinum. Okay, thank you.